Welcome everyone to another After Work Linux 20% project. Musl X32, yes, that didn't work the other day, at least not fully. I started to hack around on that, on this amazing system call stuff. And I got this to start to work, so let's just, at least with bind, but we need more than bind. So now the next thing fails, so with that, not that, but more. I also, but I want to do that slightly different now. Fix file diff. So we need to probably hack all. Where is this call? All socket calls. Apparently the stuff that you don't know on this. You work on libc's and Linux kernel stuff. The socket call apparently a little bit different. All sharing some one system call. Here socket call. Yeah, also somewhere's a comment of this is valid only because all socket syscalls are made via socket call, which allows fills unused args, slots to zero, yeah, something. Welcome everyone. So I started to patch around, and this is this kind of stuff, although I would say Musl is one of the more readable pieces of code, C libraries, glibc and others much worse. And this is the stuff that I got gray hair from already 20 years ago, and I didn't appreciate the most, right? 20 years ago, when I was new to all this Unix and Linux stuff, I was like, yeah, why does it all need to be so macro preprocessor and techy and stuff? But anyway, they have here, I mean, of course, I understand to some degree, they want here some C++-like generics, just like with preprocessor, glorified portable assembler frontend. So here they have some defines for system call. And so one thing is curious, so this probably didn't, I mean, I wonder why it's marked experimental, so I wonder if it ever worked. If it ever worked, they must have refactored this stuff in the meantime, because here they have the otherwise system call defines for zero with more arguments. And here they use long for X32. Usually, I guess they use long. I think I checked this earlier, but doesn't matter too much. This is, of course, the types suck, certainly majorly in C. Wouldn't usually use them like this, like, because int, long, why do they suck? Because they have a different bit width for architecture, for different architectures. And it's like, yeah, for like non-low level code like that, you definitely, my pro tip, use int types, h and stuff, int types and whatever the other, there's another one, but the other one, whatever. One of those is not supported by Microsoft Visual C, probably still not, whatever, but uses int six, like int bit defs, int bit like int 8 underscore t in 16, 32, in 64, and unsigned and stuff, because otherwise you get some random stuff depending on, even John Carmack of id Software years ago tweeted, like, yeah, this should have been explicit with for the most part since the beginning of C, but yeah, certainly agree with them. So this is why this sucks, because you get arbitrary stuff for each other architecture. Underscore, of course, syscall. And so yeah, here they use long because it is already LP. Yeah, IL should probably be LP64, right? Meaning in long and pointer 64. So yeah, here they use, because then this X32, the compiler has long. Long is basically on Unix systems usually. I think probably all, correct me if I'm wrong, probably long should be on Unix systems as wide as the pointers. So yeah, this is why this stuff fails. Long story short, this is why this stuff fails. And as a test I had here, I mean, we can see what happens if we make all of those longs. For some it doesn't have any side effect. Maybe I should have used some fancy substitution command. Yeah. And then we can see what happens if we're lucky. Maybe this is already, I would also not to randomly break stuff, pro tip, don't apply this to all architectures. So in T2 I would like conditionally apply that and not like build all the other PowerPC RMIPs and stuff with this hack. We also have that therefore, I slightly wonder why they have Okay, this is only if defined. So they have here syscall, syscall this or. If that is not supported, call the socket call. Amazing calling conventions and ABIs. So in sys in socket in CP, so this is their CP for, this is a CR001 for, what was CP? So that is if, so this is syscall, whatever the, was it not here or is it in the same? What was this with the syscall CP thing? So the difference there is socket call CP syscall red socket call socket call what does it stand for? If you know, leave me the comments below. What would it be? So good call. CP and then ABCDEF. Did I say CP? Whatever. Anyway, eventually we will find out. So, so good call. This was an old. So we have this stuff here. So this is basically they have here this inline function to test. Maybe some systems have introduced some socket call later. You can Google that. But this is this kind of stuff you only learn if you do this low-level stuff like this every single day. And maybe this one, but this is only if socket call is supported and called whatever. So let's Betamax this long long two. Let's see if that compiles. Let's object temp that and see. DX, let me think. EDX, no, it moves EDX to EDX. Why would it do that? Is it not an operation? I mean, here it here this is by the way sine extends, right? Move sine extends long to quarter. So that is sine extending that. Was it not fully gone? Let's just root of where's my object dump? I should have that in the history here. Here it didn't do that. This is strange. This generated code changed now. That is unexpected. Just with this cast. Why would it move EDX to E? Also, am I overlooking something trivial or is it stupid? No operation that it didn't do before the cast. Or is it, oh wait a second, or is it zeroing that, is it, it could be that this is zeroing the upper half of EDX potentially, maybe. Anyway, let's fix file diff that. And reboot that we could run this directly. But this is error prone instead of fiddling around. Usually when we fiddle around then we lose some time because we do something stupidly wrong. So let's just rebuild this. We epic thread rip that anyway. So x32 and it looks. Yeah, would be cool if we could like hack that. I wonder how well that would work. Then so the thing is also I was already nearly like, yeah, maybe not my time best spent with this stuff. Also, right, this is what I wanted. I wanted that. But yesterday on the mailing list, or some days ago, yesterday or some more days ago, Scousy John, I think, from Puppy Linux, also at least friends and family, asked unknown host. Okay, that does not work. But this still sign extends. Okay, that is not ideal. Yeah, so much to that you think like, yeah, this cast will probably do this. Yeah, see, we totally got that. Even I at times like, yeah, depending on what your portable macro preprocessor does then. So that is a regression. So that is not apparently. So this is still fine. Okay, back to the drawing board. Welcome everyone. Good news, they got GCC out of 10 and 11 running right this day. Happy hacking. Congratulations. Happy to hear that. So what I will definitely do soon, aka this winter and soon, because I would hope that, well, certainly after soon 3 years of YouTubing here, all this low-level stuff of our shiny little T2 distribution here, just freaking vanilla upstream, mostly raw Linux, getting increasingly polished and stuff, and sure, there... We opened it explicitly and intentionally bugs on GitHub for you to fix bugs at home and send patches, highly appreciated. And it nonetheless is, of course, in one of the best states ever. Of course, there's always something to do, like sort KDE, sort GNOME, add kernels like BSD or Haiku and Fuchsia or stuff. But I will soon, I started this already, this my own portable just-in-time compiler, because I'm getting, I said this a million times, getting increasingly frustrated, not only from the state of desktop Linux, but also the complexity, right? And so I will start some portable JIT with trying some high-performance ideas, like keeping it super simple, like hope, yeah, I said this a couple of times, like with 10% or less than 10, like maybe 5% of the code base, 90% of the performance, maybe even better performance in some cases, for the reason of jitting that, at least not better performance compiling, comparing my own hypothetical just-in-time stuff like Java in better and smaller, but comparing, not comparing with the best machine code GCC can generate, but maybe faster than general purpose GCC or clean code, because most people ship not CPU native but CPU least common denominator. So I would hope this dynamic JIT stuff generating single instruction multiple data SIMD that you don't have on that statically compiled C code, that at least for those cases performance could be better than static single least common denominator. Anyway, so let's fix file. So what do we patch wrong? By the way, we should probably take a look at that. So this is also why I pre-debugged that already. How I pre-debugged that. So this is long address. So I slightly wonder though. So we cast that from void. I mean, it is signed, though. This is unfortunately, it's not really a void pointer, so that comes in as an, it should not really make it matter, though. Construct socket address pointer doesn't really matter too much. So casting that to an integer, because see, we got that. Oh, wait a second, address is there. So. I mean, maybe the question is, should any of those, I mean, as a shortcut, we could make this, I mean, it makes this unsigned. Only thing is what, I wonder though, why this works for read, for, I had this, where was read was here. So in read, we have syscall cp. That is not here. So for read, that works. And for read, we have a void pointer. Doesn't matter though. Should, at least it should not matter though. Sysfix file. Syscall. So that is syscall cp. So that is. What? So this is just hiding this hidden long. This is just. Syscall cp. So that is just expand to syscall cp. But also, this stuff is sign extending this stuff though. Maybe so. This they have here some. I saw this already. They have here some SSC. So they. That is a little bit. I mean, we could try to add that though, or is this, this is really strange stuff. Also, this is in the end going to, I mean, maybe we should, but actually not casting them at all. I tried before, I think. Ah, you know what, maybe this breaks with this stuff, because here we have actually long, long. Maybe that is where the type confusion comes from, because the other system calls say go. This is what I earlier actually I tried already. The earlier I tried removing this cast altogether. I mean, it goes in here anyway and gets implicitly casted to that argument there. Although maybe this is to avoid warning though, and this is already. Man, what a mess. Because then here this call is basically, I mean, maybe it also, maybe this, yeah, because this casts this back to long, so in long should not have the point assigned, but that casts that back to long. Now wait a second, don't tell me they have here in, ah, here, look at that. This is where this comes from. They have this already, so they've, if not defined there in the other file, but we have this already defined here, so. Maybe we should, so, and yeah, so we have that there. So this is explicitly, what is it? Size of freaking one, less than 8. What size of one? Or, okay, so this is, so this thing is size of why would they do this trickery? I mean, this is always true. I mean, why even bother with that? Or do they? What do they do here? Given that this is always true, it's always that. Yeah, and pro tip, add there some freaking comment, because then people waste their time guru meditating of what, why the actual heck they do that. I'm curious, let's grab for SCC, I think. in all of those, I'm curious, maybe x32, yeah, as I expected, x32 is the only architecture that does this trickery. So in my opinion, as far as I've seen, the bug is in this at least the main bug. And if you have an idea why they do it like this, leave me in the comments below. We could maybe run git blame or log on that. And so how do we fix this? So all the regular system calls go through this macro trickery, and also, yeah, having all this macro, unreadable macro stuff here, only additional wrappers of potential sign extending stuff only for x32, right? As far as I've seen, no other. I wonder if, do they have MIPS N32 or what do they do for MIPS N32? Do they also? No, they don't have that. Pedro is working on sockets today. Happy to hear that. So yeah, they have N32. They don't have this trickery for that, though. They have long here for some long. So I think the problem is, so here what usually happens is, given what we probably could do is, so I mean, to finish my sentence, I'm already ahead of myself. So I think it usually works because this macro gets evaluated for the types of all of those arguments here. The problem is that the socket thing is not instantiating that as macros, but with this wrapper inline function, so that the type stuff is not applied there. So basically the type information is lost here. I mean, first of all, this stuff is casting all this stuff. And so here we cast this information away, right? This already doesn't make the most sense. Not sure if this fixes some bugs, hides some bugs, but recurring pro tip at freaking comments. I would actually say this code has, yeah, here should be some what this freaking, I mean, I've not yet found what _CP does, though. Maybe we will eventually find that out. But so this is losing the type information, that is not ideal. And then it looks like we could do some evaluation there. We have here this is, and this. I'm not sure if we need this socket call. Maybe we should actually check that is this call. There was some other x32 bits, this call. Do we have, no, maybe we don't have that here, at least that I would see. Let's this socket. No, we don't have socket call here, at least not that I would immediately see that. So this might be for some other architectures, depending on the history and stuff and compatibility and so on. So if we remove this explicit casting, that only makes us lose types. And then not do this alt socket call this an M. This macro stuff will be fun. So we have one, so if we directly do this call, Might be entirely stupid and not work, but let's try that. Where is this CP thing? So this is CP, this is not CP, this call. NM, so, and this would be this call CP. And this is gone. This was a CP wrapper thing. And of course, this probably breaks some other architectures, but we will only apply this for x32 for a test anyway. So this would be my idea of let this other macro stuff take care of it. What's this call? This number SC. Do we have? We had there a socket. Okay, this is ZC. This ABC. Okay, so this we don't need because we would have. This would be the socket call NM. So let's hope for the best. Let's maybe see what happens here. This call red. So this is a dash capital E preprocessor for bind FD and stuff. Syscall return, syscall red. Syscall 6 or 6 arguments. All the size of stuff. Looks like maybe it. Oh, we would also would need to. Because this make file doesn't regenerate stuff from the header, so that would be. Wrong. Bind. Let's touch this file. Object dump that. That is the local one. Bind. It looks even more different. I don't. DXDIS. So maybe it works potentially. I mean, maybe I should do a shortcut and copy that to this root user lib, I think. So much to ash. Darn, I. Okay, change root. This root. Okay, of course, it's fine. Oops, hey, it works. It freaking works, yay. Yeah, somehow why I always for 20 years need to be the one who needs to patch such stuff. I mean, of course, again, this is not universal. Probably the real fix is either maybe surround the stuff with if the socket call thing, or because, so I don't quite see how we can fix this, because as I expected or had the impression, expected, figured, determined, guesstimated, that with this wrapper function, with this long argument that is obviously casting the types away, losing the type information. So I'm not sure if this is really fixable with this wrapper function. And obviously we probably gain an instruction cycle or two with not having this if test stuff there, potentially something. Where is my fix file diff there? Vi that and remove the previous patch because we appended that. So then the question would be, how well does it work? And these are at least two system calls. First bind failed, and after I previously patched bind send, socket receive, socket send, I think I don't have this in the scrollback. Do I? whatever. Actually, we can check. You know what? Let's cleanly build that, and then also. By the way, I also need to. By the way, did I? No, I didn't. Musel job one musel and x32 musel. Yeah, I wanted to nearly already give up. It's usually not my style to give up, but there's only so much time of before work, after work, Sundays, midnights, and 20% project I can put into all this stuff, and also Patreon, GitHub sponsorship, and GoFundMe and YouTube memberships and stuff. Yeah, just with this YouTube channel. So yeah, thanks to you watching, sharing, liking, and subscribing and stuff. I've done it. Of course, the question is how stable it is. So this only affects socket stuff. So all the non-socket stuff should be, or not should be, yeah, should most definitely not be affected. Famous last words: how rocket crashed into Mars and Moon and stuff. Ping that. So yeah, that works. Didn't work before. And the system calls are bind and receive from. So if also receive from previously, after I patched bind previously some 30 minutes ago, then receive from also failed, whatever, where is bind? Or send to, maybe send to actually first. Yeah, probably send to. So yeah, that should be send to, receive from, I guess. And what else is with socket? We could actually test then if more stuff works, or actually how complete is the build. I mean, the only other thing I think, well, also obviously we need to freaking test it, right? It's one thing to YOLO that after work. Cheers. But also freaking ship it. I mean, yeah, obviously Microsoft ship it. Yeah, there was at least one more thing that didn't build. That I remember that I skipped. At least one more important thing, my ADM log. So that should be some. Yeah, proc PS. I mean, yeah, sure, this stuff we will simply not ship. The only other thing that didn't build was proc PS. Let's maybe tackle that as well. And as we are a little bit crazy here, as you might have noticed, wasting all our lifetime with this stuff nobody else is doing. Now we're here live on YouTube. Proc PS. Maybe I put back on the to-do list for sometime soon, the next 6 months or so, to bring back Clang-based, not GCC, but Clang-based. I've done this a year ago on previous videos there, live stream and stuff, but it is broken again upstream. So yeah, most likely need some work. And you might ask why would I be so crazy to do that? It would of course be some people like non, nowadays it's fashionable of non-GNU stuff, but also for even smaller container systems and stuff, not to have two compilers, because right now this has GCC and Clang, so getting rid of some GNU stuff of 100 megabyte of compiler goodness. But yeah, that is not for this release. We have already done way too much, obviously, as recurring theme here, per usual. So what's going on with proc PS? You would also think that once upon a time did build, but something code set. So where do we get that from? Also, that didn't say because. So the usual stuff that may or may not be in your C library. Did you mean UT host size? Why is it use underscores if we have UT host size? What else do we have there? Code set, but we have also code set. Does it have proc escape code set? Oh, this is actually testing for GNU C library already. Does musel fake GNU library? GNU library? Greater 6? GNU Library Greater 6? What? So let's see if we find this in some header somewhere. There is, maybe it's missing, only, oh no, this is lib. Define code set fleng info. Maybe we just need lang info, code set 14, I have no idea. Could try that. Maybe this is, header should just be there. Oops. Do we have one less? Apparently, maybe. This is all in W, this is underscore, underscore. What do we have here? If not define host size, or... Okay, we apparently are if not defined. What? Maybe we also have forgotten, or not we, maybe they have also forgotten to include some vital header simply there. Here is, okay, we include here something, maybe UTMPX, maybe simply either that way or so we have it. That was an easy fix, didn't even expect that. This is of course only in hotfix, might not be entirely clean, so hotfix mu or hotfix patch musel. And there we have it, that would be then complete unexpectedly. So even for me, how many, even fast, hey, only freaking 35 freaking streaming minutes. So yeah, that's how we do it here at Exacode. Don't delay. Try our services. Paperless, probably. Me too. Yeah. That's how we do it. And if you need some embedded partner and otherwise some stuff, you know where you find it. Linux kernel. Let's maybe. So the only other thing I noticed already, if before you applaud this and yay, I want that. One drawback, of course, of X32 by nature with 32-bit pointers, higher performance for more compact data structures, more cache efficiency, less memory bandwidth and stuff. But you have only 4 gigabyte or a little, yeah, probably nearly, I would guess, unlike 32-bit x86, where you usually had 3 gigabyte user space, 1 gigabyte kernel split, historically, mostly, usually by default, I guess. I would assume that you get the full, nearly full 4 gigabyte address space of 32-bit pointers, probably, maybe, but and that usually is enough, maybe even for a Firefox or Chrome tab, but not enough for setstandard. So I tried earlier already to build the Linux kernel natively, and downloading just the tarball and recompressing it with setstandard failed with out of memory eventually. So we compress with 18 ultra, dash dash ultra or so, 18. So maybe in T2, and so this also means that if you run T2 natively on 32-bit stuff, like your G4 cube or our PS3 user land, for example, which also defaults to 32-bit for the same memory efficiency on the PS3, that would mean you can't by default with T2 like build your kernel. Well, it would take probably a week on the PS3 anyway, but it would fail compressing setstandard without a virtual memory address space, no matter how much swap you add to that. So maybe we would want to add some logic there with in T2. I mean, you would normally not nowadays want to build such large packages on 32-bit machines, I would assume, but if a G4 cube or whatever, if an old-fashioned x86 is everything you have and you need to compile it for a week, then maybe you should. So maybe we should auto detect like if 32-bit whatever, which memory, something in shell, we would need to do this in shell in the config, then not use dash dash ultra 18 or something, but like not ultra and I don't know, 14 or something of that sort, gets idea. What else do we have there? So yeah, that the only other thing is we would need to conditional apply that. So to commit this for you to play along at home. We have here at times some diffs and do we need to copy that from somewhere? So yeah, patch files here. So that's how you do that. So we would need to musl. Actually, we can also like we should rename that. Dot x32 does not work because that is not a like real architecture name, and T2 is the only dot architecture, and stuff of course only works with real architectures, and the real architecture is x86-64. So we could maybe name the syscall, and we could also name it hotfix, but otherwise syscall, or actually socket call. Patch x32, of course this will not magically apply. This is why we would need some here, for example, actually we have, oh, actually this is post install, we would need that. Somewhere else, post install, this is all, okay, post install and pre-make. Needs this somewhere else, so let's copy that to here. Additionally, so if that, then add, actually I wonder, I think that could work. That probably should expand potentially, then we don't need to fully type that out. x32 musl job 1 musl. Actually, I googled the previous live stream. I googled this problem, found nothing. I just googled that again before this live stream, found nothing. So I have no idea what other distributions do. Although maybe it's a regression. Maybe others who Gentoo and Debian or so who may, or does Debian have musl? Maybe not. But other brave folks who might have tried that. Maybe it worked accidentally. Maybe this is a new regression or who knows what. Or they never got so far and bootstrapping this stuff because T2 obviously makes it easy and snappy and stuff. So whatever the case might be, I didn't find any other. Otherwise, I would have shamelessly stolen that from other Linux distributions, but Googled that twice, didn't find anything. So musl, did we apply x32? We applied that. That nicely worked. Okay, Linux build, but that's, so this is generic. We would also need to fix that. Previous video, we updated the man pages. Maybe we say goodbye to the man pages for now. So this would be one of the very last things. So maybe I do, let's make a note before I forget this. Sometimes I forget my own thoughts, as you might have seen here. So, musl install. Okay, hey, we have done that. Amazing. Do we build, so yeah, this is still ongoing. So then, so the last thing is, the second last thing, one thing is fix new man pages shared files, and the other thing was, all right, the other thing is urgently, you know what, let's maybe also do this time, just because we are perfectionists. And the other thing is the, is it this one or shared MIME database? Wait a second, watch. Wrapper, where do we have? What was it shared MIME? At least I will, let's copy that, and when we do it, I will remember this or because one wrapper or was it icon themes? Wrap GTK icon themes, a couple of those though. Maybe as we have our delayed already a little bit, or little, I mean, not that someone would pay us for that and stuff. If we make it too good, you couldn't afford it anymore anyway. Let's maybe add both of this to the list. And so that would be like this stuff, then really the last stuff for this time. We overdone it excessively already anyway. And then let's, last thing, what time? 57, need to leave soonish. X32 Musel. Let's YOLO over that. Let's, so that probably was everything. So yeah, we have, yeah, this we can live without. And then let's quickly install that. That would be VMs Linux, Linux or test, yeah, here. Then let's create ISO of X32 Musel and oops. Yeah, of course, some Unicode, thank you very much. Also, errorless mode, great, what do we even do there? ISO, I want. And that looks good. I also wonder, somehow KVM doesn't autoload for me, at least on this old workstation still anymore. Also, I think once upon a time that was working, but whatever. So that would be X32. First time ever we install that in our life. Maybe it works, maybe it doesn't. Hello? What's going on? Enable KVM. CD-ROM. What did we enable KVM? Why does nothing happen? Hello? Ah, right, full screen. Ah, so clever me. Also released new mini SED version. This is mini SED. It's not some proprietary, highly confidential stuff. Installation. There we have that. So booted instantly, obviously. Install. Let's see how far this goes. Let's edit partition map because why not? Let's fully test maximum test stuff of new primary. All of it. Yes, wipe it, please. New Linux there. Then just recreating everything to test that all the file system stuff works. Create file system, BetterFS. Install everything full. Hey, this works now. So yeah, this is a super expensive fix, right? I debugged over not only the system call stuff, but also that the installer even worked on a previous video. That was pipe short reads. Yeah, so this we have sometimes something with locals. So this is just some tips or something. I think this is harmless. It's just cosmetic. Test. Paul says Alpine is Musel. Yeah, but we have X32, right? Of X32 is a special flavor of 32-bit pointers. So I would guess they probably have the full 64-bit regular old-fashioned stuff. We have here the highly efficient latest and greatest that people want to remove it already from the Linux kernel. At least they discuss it sometimes. In my opinion, it's not so much extra code stuff in the Linux kernel for that, so yeah. All right, so there was one cosmetic I saw there already, at least ldconfig not existing with Musel, so yeah, reboot, please. And we could add that to the to-do of do we have ldconfig post install optional ldconfig not with Musel or whatever. and installed from the HD. So grub is coming up, Linux kernel is coming up, stuff is this bloody file. Did I not? Maybe I didn't patch that correctly away. This is just some mostly cosmetic debug. Hello, DD. Not post install. I wanted profile. Hello, profile CSH. We could actually say, let's test, like, do we get Ethan? All right. Okay, we can't release it that quickly. We need to. There are some path mismatches, actually. There's some lib. I saw this already. I forgot about that. There is some stuff in lib and some stuff in lib x32. Nothing super major, but obviously we should probably polish that a little bit before releasing, because otherwise people will run into that playing along at home. Just stressing stuff a little bit. So more sophisticated socket stuff works. Can also make this even larger for you to read at home. Theoretically this could be a tiny little bit faster than glibc or whatever, your mileage may vary. Permanently please. And all right, also move that to t2 trunk of config does. So yeah, I also patched this. This also didn't work the other day. I patched the default linker output to F32 previous videos. So that probably should match. Let's try emerge something for maximum stability testing. Ripple IOS. Yeah, this is harmless, this is just cosmetic. So, this is division by zero attempted. That is not amazing. Maybe something not working, but whatever. Last but not least, we could feel lucky and start X. And something works. Here. Something even freaking works. What is this xterm? We had this in the other video. Why does xterm not work? The last time I suspected that they want this the FPDS may be mounted with other partitions, other permissions or whatever. Also, let's tmax. Tmax works. Would tmax not use the same PTS infrastructure? Or xterm is compiled wrong. Do we have rxvt? At least x works. That is already more than better than nothing. The other stuff we need to investigate could potentially be a also wrong context menu. We don't even have. So yeah, better than nothing. TWM. So we have only, what else do we have here? Why we have here xterm though? Why is here? Okay, this is just not as fancy application launcher. X is good enough to freaking work. Do we have something with xterm? Fail to load driver with whatever. Box DRM load driver or something. Anyway, yeah, so but pretty good, I would say, from zero to mostly working. Certainly something for you to play along at home. To add, so we would also need to add X32 Musolibdir confusions. That would be something, but yeah, leave in the comments below how much thrilled you are. And what else do you want to see, like on the mailing list, the Clang stuff? X32 socket call to actually work. Yeah, that's it for this video. Pretty successful, I would say. As usual, there's always some stuff to do. Especially if you freaking support 25 build variants and stuff. The only last thing, and I really need to go. I really need to go, and then we set you some more 5 minutes. Some 5 minutes more, 5 minutes longer is which architectures do we build? Because Spark is not. Did I switch to AVR 32? Okay, fine. Yeah, because Spark is. Yeah, this is fine with me. So yeah, that would be the final list. 1, 2, 3. Oh wait, we have 2 Usilipsi. Okay, the more the merrier. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 24. Okay, 24 is 2 dozen. And yeah, then more stuff to come next quarters and winters and stuff. So this probably should be the final list. Do we have Itanium IA? Oh yeah, we have that. It's randomly crashing, but at least something. Alright, we also fixed proc PSO, so that would be that. Did I not commit that already? Apparently not. Maybe I should. Alright, I didn't commit this because I thought I'd do that more clever. That maybe I clean this up a little bit more. So, yeah, I guess as much. What have I done here? Why? All right, what? No changes base music? What? Or did I what? Wait a second. Something I have. Ah, proc base. I don't know what I was looking at. Sometimes it happens too. Don't see the tree in between the forest here. The patch in between the patches. So here, that should be pretty good. Leave in the comments below which architecture, which build you like to see, most thrilled, excited about. Welcome everyone. Good to see you all. What keyboard do you use? Sun, previous video, Sun Type 5, I think, with an USB, like DIY, previous video DIY USB converter. Ironically, I use that mostly not only because I have it here with my Sun Spark stuff, also yeah, it's not the most amazing membrane keyboard and stuff. I only used it for this freaking extra 10 keys here, and I patched OBS previous video. I patched OBS to have a scene selection here with those 10, like scene 1 to... but Wayland broke that, so now I'm using the Subpar keyboard for a scene selection that doesn't work anymore. That is super annoying. Otherwise, I have a couple of other stuff. Otherwise, I use a 10 keyless Tech Yoda 2. Previous videos there, more main channel, with Cherry MX Red Silent Red. Yeah, stuff like that. Anyway, so here I had to test the printer, so that is actually was it visible? Didn't even realize it. That happens when I had to test the printer, so just some new stuff. Can we also focus on that probably? Anyway, test the printer, print some stuff, and then it's not the most visible. But yeah. Someone noticed. I probably need to do that better. Yeah, I carried a Xerox Phaser 8500 precious printer out of our storage because we had some water damage there and I wanted to test whether we need to e-waste it or it freaking still works. And it freaking still works. Yeah, Phaser 8500 VEX, how to pronounce it, VEX. Freaking thing. Prints with, warms up wax and prints with wax, crazy stuff. Anyway, still works. That's it for this video, and I hope you enjoy this, our increasingly best release ever. Certainly have some P3 stuff to test and stuff, yeah, but now I need to run. As usual, I need to run 5 minutes later. 4,401 drop frames, 3.7% with just 2 freaking Mbit because not recommendable. Vodafone 1.5 freaking Mbit just to document this craziness for legal reasons. Maybe I need to sue them. Yeah, you can't make this stuff up. 4,000 drop frames, 3.6% with not even 1.4 freaking Mbit. This is a business. Vodafone DOCSIS cable line 550 Mbit. That is how Vodafone recurrently treats their customers, aka like shit. That's it for this video. I hope you learned something. And don't. Mike Tech asked what I have my thoughts about Rust in the news kernel. I made a video about this that some people watch you. So, yeah, I need to go. And if we continue talking, then we digress. You probably want to watch that. Can we crash? Let's check here, I guess. That here. But yes, thanks for asking. I hope that works. And don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. And I hope to see you soon for more fun. More